Hello everyone, good morning. Let's solve the problem B from the weekly contest 387. Now, before going into the problem, I will recommend you to try this problem for at least 20 minutes. So if you couldn't able to solve, then you can come and watch the video solutions. So let's understand the problem. You are given a zero indexed integer matrix grid and an integer k, and we need to return the number of submatrices that contains the top left element of the grid and have some less than or equals to k. Whenever he is asking submatrices, these are the favorite questions for the interviewers. You may expect these type of problems in an interview. So understanding this is quite helpful for you. Now suppose if you are having a grid, and we need to definitely have the top left element of the grid should be included, and we need to calculate the submatrices. Submatrices is something which can form the rectangle. Now if you are having like this, this is not a submatrix, right? But if you are including one more index, this is the my submatrix. Now we need to calculate all the submatrix which are starting at top left element, and we need to check how many submatrices have sum less than or equals to k. So I think you understood this question. Let's see this example. We have 7. And this is my submatrix 7 and 6, which is less than k, and we have 7 6 3, and that is also less than k. And if you are going with 7 and 6 less than k, but if you are taking this, now we have 7 6, we are getting 13, 6 plus 6 we are 12, 25 which is greater than k, so we are not included. So we need to calculate this. So how are you going to calculate it? So which type of approaches you are going to follow? Think like, now suppose you are at this position, you will go till the left and you will calculate all the sums, right? And if you are at this position you will go left top, and like suppose if you are having a matrix, whenever you are at this position you will calculate all these sums. When you are at this positions you will calculate all this. When you are at this, you will calculate this. In this way, you will calculate all the sums. So if you are doing that, he's saying 1000 n into m is 1000, 1000 into 1000. That means we will get the time complexity, because every time when you are at this position, you need to go till the top and you need to calculate. So what is the most efficient way? Suppose consider we have only an array. And if you want to include top left element, so I am going to include this, and if you want the matrix to be this, right, you need to add both these elements. So I will add both these elements, and if you are here, then you will add 3 elements, here 4 elements, here 5 elements. So if you add all this, these are all my submatrices with sum greater than. Now if you see here, now suppose we have 7 to 9, so consider 7 to 9 as my matrix 7, 2 and 9. So only consider 1D matrix, So here I will be 7 and it will be 9 and it will be 18, right? 18, because this is the only thing it is possible. Now if you are, if you want to add new more elements, if you are adding new elements, suppose we have 1, 5. Now we have 1 and comma 5. If you have 1, 5, now we got 7 and 9 we have added here, we are introducing new elements 1 comma 5. Same thing I will do here, so it will be my 1, so it will be my 6. So this is my prefix sum, so what I will do, this is my 9, this is my 6, in the same way I will do for rest of the elements, 18, and here we are having same element, so it will be 1 6, we have 0, it will be 6. So in this way I will do the prefix sum, for every single array, like one dimensional array, you can think one dimensional arrays. After calculating this, we have got these elements. So if I want to include this element 7 7 9, and if I want to calculate this submatrix sum, what you can do here. Now we had this sum, right? We have this sum and we have this sum, and this is stored in these two indexes. So I will do addition of these two, 9 plus 6 which is 15, right? Now at this index you are having 18, 18 till here, and till here we have 6. So we have calculated all this sum 18 plus 6, which is 24. Now if I want to consider these elements, this sum. Now this sum is, now we have here 7 and here we have 1 8. Now we have added 7 and we got 8, and here we have 2, right? So we are going to add that. So these are all my column prefix sums. So it is my 10. Now when you want this matrix, see this submatrix, you have calculated all these elements till here. So that is 10, and now we have 9 and 15. We have 9 and here we have 15, and we have 8 introduced here. So we will add 8, 23. So we will build this new prefix sum grid. Now if you see here, now if you see the coding part, now we will iterate. I is equals 0, I less than n, j is equals to 1, j less than m. That means at every index, sir, for every row we are calculating the prefix sums. V of I j is equals to V of I plus V of j minus 1. Now we need all the columns as well, right? Because if we want the columns, if you want the whole submatrix, we need to add row and we need to add the columns as well. That's why we are doing the columns here. I is equals 0, I less than m, j is equals to 1, j less than n. So we are doing the column here, and we are iterating and we are checking whether my V of ij is less than or equals to k. If it is less than, I am returning the answer. So if you see here, the time complexity would be order of n into n only, n into n. So try to understand why exactly we are doing the row sum and the column sum. So I think I have explained it quite clearly. So if you couldn't able to understand, please do rewatch or think by yourself how we have done that. So I think you have gained learned something new from this video. So if you like, please do like the channel, and please do subscribe. I will see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye.